Well, it's time now for the top business story of the day. Jameson Burko joins us now from BNN Bloomberg. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Beth.
So yesterday you were here telling us that there was an imminent deal between Aurora and possibly Coca-Cola.
Not necessarily imminent, but they're definitely in some serious talks.
Okay, so what's the latest on this now?
It seems like Aurora is sending the message that, you know, Coke would be a great partner, was what Terry Booth, the CEO, told us from Edmonton yesterday, but that he doesn't necessarily need them. They've been in talks with as many beverage companies over the last 3 months as they've had. In 3 months, they've had three different beverage companies banging on their doors and trying to send the message that there's lots of potential partnerships they could tie up.
But investors really liked, at first blush, they really liked potential partnership yesterday. Both stocks were up.
Well, it sends the message that there is a serious, serious contender in not just the kind of intoxicant side of cannabis beverages that are supposed to be coming in a little over a year, right, Ben, once those regulations are in place, but also on the sort of health product side, because Coke doesn't seem all that interested in creating a drink that will get you stoned, more creating a drink that will give you the more kind of mellow effects that people get after 7 hours of listening to the Doobie Brothers.
we've talked about this before, that investors are quite bullish on all these products coming to market.
Sure.
And yet we don't know if they ultimately will.
Yep.
The government, the federal government does have the right. They have a year after this legislation comes in, after legalization happens. They have a year to decide whether they even want to legalize these other products.
And who's to say that they'll even do it within a year?
Right.
Right, Ben? What's the consequence to the government for blowing past their self-imposed deadline? And, I mean, would this be the first time ever a government didn't get something done by the time that they said they would? I mean, even this mid-October legalization is several months later than they had originally wanted. So, I mean, that's a risk as well, is laden with risk, which always makes me wonder, why is the beverage space so interested in this when they're going to have to science the crap out of those products to figure out how they're going to work? Meanwhile, the snack makers and the food industry, while we've seen tons of speculation that they're sniffing around, haven't really actually dipped their toe in the water yet.
Jameson Burko, really fascinated by this conversation. I know we're going to continue it in the days and weeks to come. Thank you so much.
You bet, Ben.